Airtable Forms is one of my most favorite features. It makes it so simple to get the information into our Airtable bases. It works great on mobile. And that's one of the biggest barriers to having our data be intelligent, is that we don't get it into a format that makes it intelligent, and having these forms makes it so much easier. In my last video, I showed how I am breaking down all the tasks for my agency and how I'm going to be offloading a lot of those tasks to an assistant. For example, all these ones that say new VA, those are all tasks that are going to be taken over by this person. And so one of the things I want them to do is to look at all my email. They literally are going to be taking over my inbox. And one of the main things that happens is I'll get new leads that come in via email, and I'll need them to fill out a form to give information about who those leads are and even do some research, etc. And so within Airtable, we have the ability, of course, to have external forms that we share with other people. And so what they would do is obviously put in the date that the lead started. Maybe they were checking email from yesterday, and they'll put in the name of the person. And one thing I didn't like, though, is how the default forms have these single selects as drop downs. I felt that was a little cumbersome. So we can actually go into here, go into this item, and actually say, let's make it as a list. So I'm just going to click that. And now when I refresh this, you'll be able to see that the scope now is more pulled out here, because there are going to be multiple things they're going to be checking, and I don't want them to have to click, you know, shift click, etc. So perhaps this lead, Tom Jones, wanted a brand new logo and a website and some copywriting. Then they put in obviously their company, the email, the phone number, the website, and then the status. Here I'd actually keep it as a drop down because, well, they'd only ever be selecting one, and it's really almost always going to be either open, or perhaps the initial lead wanted to meet and the VA decided that it was a good opportunity and they just scheduled them in, because I'm going to give them that kind of a leeway once I train them up properly. And so perhaps they would say triage scheduled because they would have scheduled using my Calendly link, etc. The VA would never put in a verbal estimate. I mean, they probably never even score them as far as how good the budget is, how much they respect the process, and how good the project is. I feel like I'm the only one that really do that for the company right now. Same thing for conversion guests. So what I would do here for this form, the one that I would at least share with my VA, is I would take out all these fields. I literally would just, you know, move these out. I think that's all the fields that I would like. Let's go ahead and refresh this, make it nice and trim. Hope you've enjoyed this. Let me know if you have any questions.